Welcome to UGC e-Pathshala, PG Learning and Food Science. I am Shajini Judith from the Department of Home Science, Women's Christian College. I am going to be discussing with you the postmortem changes in meat today. This module that I am going to teach you now will help you to understand the physiochemical changes that take place when muscle is converted to meat and its effect on the cooking quality of meat. The conversion of muscle to meat involves a number of physical and chemical changes which take place over a period of several hours or even several days. After the animal is slaughtered, the animal loses a lot of blood. The animal bleeds to death after it is slaughtered. This process is referred to as exsanguination. Exsanguination is the act of removing as much blood as possible from the animal. When the animal completely bleeds to death, this marks the beginning of a series of postmortem changes in the muscle. So, postmortem changes in meat can be defined as the process of converting the living muscle into meat soon after the animal is slaughtered. After the animal is slaughtered, the animal bleeds to death and the oxygen in its muscle is rapidly depleted. So, it is known that impartial bleeding is a major cause of early meat spoilage. So, when the animal is slaughtered, it should be ensured that the animal completely bleeds to death and as much as possible is removed from the body of the animal. So, now let's look into the series of changes that take place after the animal is killed and when the blood from the body of the animal is removed. There are four main changes that take place. Number one is the acidification of the muscles. Number two, the development of rigor mortis. The third is the resolution of rigor. And the fourth is the tenderization of meat that happens when the rigor passes away or resolves. And the tenderization of meat happens when the meat is aged. The first change that I talked about during the postmortem change of meat is the acidification of the muscles. The acidification of the muscles happens because of circulatory failure to the muscles. We all know that the main function of the circulatory system is to transport essential nutrients and oxygen to the muscle and then carry away the waste products from the muscle. But what happens after the death of the animal is this line of communication between the muscle and its external environment is completely eliminated. So the muscle is not, the blood is not able to carry oxygen and nutrients to the muscle now. In the living cell of a living animal, oxygen is picked up by the lungs, it is carried to the cells wherever it is needed by the hemoglobin, which is a red pigment that is present in the blood. Likewise, the myoglobin that is present in the muscle cells, it also has a greater attraction for oxygen than does hemoglobin. This important characteristic of myoglobin, which has a greater attraction for oxygen, helps to transfer oxygen from the blood to the muscle cells. The myoglobin also performs another function. It stores the oxygen until it is used by the cells for further metabolism. After the death of the animal, the circulatory system ceases to function or it comes to a halt, whereby the animal does not gets its oxygen supply, and then the aerobic pathway of metabolism, which is involved in the production of ATP through the citrate cycle and the cytochrome system, it stops functioning. So because the muscles are not getting its oxygen, anaerobic glycolysis cannot take place. So energy metabolism now shifts to the anaerobic pathway where the ATP production is considerably reduced, as a result of which the energy produced is also considerably less, and this little amount of energy that is produced by the anaerobic glycolysis will help in maintaining the structural integrity and the temperature of the cells sometime after the death of the animal. So this is what I was talking about. So when the circulatory system ceases to function, when the oxygen supply gets depleted, instead of aerobic metabolism or aerobic glycolysis, anaerobic glycolysis sets in. Pyruvate, which is produced as a result of carbohydrate metabolism, is not able to enter the Krebs cycle and form acetyl-CoA and then form the ATP. But then now what happens because of lack of oxygen is pyruvate gets converted to lactic acid, and lactic acid, its accumulation increases in the muscles, and when lactic acid concentration increases, because of incomplete oxidation, ATP production also falls. So as a result of this lactic acid that is produced and the lactic acid which is accumulating in the muscles now, the pH decreases. There is a fall in the pH, or there is a decline in the pH. This is because the circulatory system is not functioning anymore, and the lactic acid produced by the anaerobic metabolism, the pyruvate, instead of being transported to the liver for getting converted into glucose or glycogen, it remains in the muscle, and the concentration of the lactic acid increases. When the lactic acid concentration increases, there is a lowering in the pH of the meat. This makes the meat acidic. When a condition like this happens, this affects the water holding capacity of the meat. It affects the juiciness of the meat, and affects the cooking quality of the meat as the end result. And the meat now, because of the decrease in pH, it also becomes pale in color. So far I have told you about how the muscles become acidified after the animal is slaughtered. This is because the circulatory system stops to function, and the pyruvate is being converted to lactate through the anaerobic glycolysis system. Now the next change that takes place is the actual rigor mortis. In Latin, rigor mortis is referred to as the stiffness of death. This is because, I've just told you about how the lactic acid concentration increases now and how the pH falls. In a situation like this, there are permanent bridge cross linkages or permanent bonds that are formed between the ATP. Also between the actin and myosin, which are the contractile components of the muscle. So these permanent bonds or linkages that get established between actin and myosin, they make the meat stiff, or it affects the cooking quality of the meat by making it very hard. So this is called as the actual rigor mortis state. When the animal is cooked during this state, it is devoid of juiciness, and and the flavor of the meat is also affected if the meat is going to be cooked when it is at this state. And it is believed that the more lactic acid in the muscle of the animal, when the animal is killed, if the animal is going to be chased or hunted before it is killed, then there is more lactic acid in the muscle of the animal, and the rigor mortis sets in very quickly. And when the animal is hunted or chased before it is slaughtered, the muscle glycogen stores are also depleted rapidly, and the ATP production falls to a drastic level, to such a state that it is not able to maintain the muscle in a relaxed state. So this flow chart will just summarize the changes that I have been talking to you about now. So after the slaughter of the animal, the blood circulation stops, and as a result of which the oxygen level decreases, and the pigment myoglobin is not able to store in oxygen for metabolism. So the respiration stops and anaerobic glycolysis sets in, as a result of which the ATP and the creatinine phosphate production falls, and then because of the increasing accumulation of lactic acid in the muscles, the pH decreases. When pH decreases and when permanent bonds are established between actin and myosin, rigor mortis, or the stiffening of the muscles, set in. After some time, the proteins in the muscle of the animal, they get denatured, and the action of the proteolytic enzymes begin, and this further helps in leads to protein denaturation. Okay, the next stage, so now we've seen about how the muscles get acidified and how they pass into the rigor mortis stage. Now after a lapse of time, rigor passes off, or the rigor passes away, or it gets resolved. the time, the length of time with which this rigor passes away or it is resolved depends on the speed with which the rigor first developed, and it also depends on the condition, the temperature at which the muscle is stored after the rigor is passed, after the rigor mortis sets in. Usually for the rigor to pass away, it may require 5 or 6 days or longer, or in refrigerated conditions it might happen very quickly, or at so it is essential for the meat to be held in a cold temperature, say between 2 to 5 degrees for about 2 or 3 days for the rigor to pass away. So it is also said that the rigor passes away more rapidly from animals or from, you know, from a carcass in which rigor develops early. So when the rigor passes away, the muscles become soft and pliable once again, the juiciness becomes better, and all these changes to collectively are termed as ripening or aging. Aging or ripening happens only with the resolution of rigor. So the greatest physical change that takes place after rigor mortis has set in is the increasing tenderness in meat that is contributed by the process called as aging or ripening. So how is meat aged or ripened? Meat is usually held at a temperature of 2 to 5 degrees for about 2 to 4 weeks, and this condition which brings about an increasing tenderness in meat is called as aging or ripening. This practice helps to tenderize the meat, increase the tenderness and flavor, and the muscle becomes soft and pliable once again. But during what happens during aging is there is a progressive tenderization of meat that is developing owing to the proteolytic enzymes that are being secreted now, and they help to denature the proteins. So the permanent bonds that had been established between actin and myosin, they get denatured, and the muscle develops juiciness and becomes soft and pliable once again. Now these enzymes that are responsible for bringing about the denaturation of the proteins are called as the cathepsins or the proteolytic enzymes. And it is said that the best flavor and the greatest tenderness is produced when meat is aged between 2 to 4 weeks. But then care should be taken to control the humidity when meat is being aged in the cold room in order to prevent microbial invasion. And the meat also should be wrapped with a polythene cover or a foil to minimize drying and weight loss. And meat can also be, I told you about how meat can be aged at a lower temperature, but meat can even be aged at higher temperatures for a practically shorter period of time. This is usually done commercially, but when meat is aged at a higher temperature, ultraviolet light or rays are usually used to keep the surface bacterial growth under control. Now to summarize the changes that take place after slaughtering, it can be classified into three stages: the pre-rigor mortis state, the rigor mortis state, and the post-rigor mortis state. So during the pre-rigor mortis state, I told you what happens. The muscle is soft and pliable, but then after the slaughter of the animal, the oxygen supply to the muscles is cut off, as a result of which active glycolysis cannot take place, so anaerobic glycolysis sets in, and glycogen, pyruvate, instead of getting converted to glycogen, gets converted to lactate, as a result of which there is a drop in the pH. Then the second state is the actual rigor mortis state. This is where the muscles become stiff because of the permanent cross linkages that are formed between actin and myosin, and the meat muscle fibers also, there's loss of extensibility, and then this happens very rapidly during this state. And usually the rigor mortis occurs 1 to 2 hours after postmortem, or sometimes it may last even for a longer period of time in the case of mammals. Post rigor, the muscles generally become tender once again. It's because of the activity of the proteolytic enzymes, the cathepsins. They denature the proteins and increase the tenderness and juiciness in meat. And usually the meat attains its tenderness when meat is aged. That is when the tenderization process begins. So just a recap of whatever I have taught you now. So the, after the animal is slaughtered, it completely bleeds to death. The blood circulation stops. Glycogen gets converted to lactic acid. There is a drop in ATP production. There's a drop because of the increase in lactic acid concentration. The pH falls. The stiffening of the muscles happen. That is rigor mortis. And then there are certain proteolytic enzymes that get activated. They denature the proteins. They break down the bonds between the actin and myosin, which are the contractile proteins. So that's called as resolution of rigor, or the rigor passes away, and then the meat becomes soft and pliable once again because of the juiciness and tenderness which comes in through the aging process. But if the temperature at which the meat is aged and the humidity is not controlled, then there are chances that microorganisms can go on the surface of the meat and also bring about spoilage. In addition, the fat content of the meat can also be oxidized, leading to spoilage in meat. Okay, now the meat that has gone through rigor mortis, after the rigor passes away, I told you it becomes tender and juicy once again. But then meat can also be tenderized by the use of proteolytic enzymes like the cathepsins. Now the cathepsins are naturally present in the muscle of the meat, and they help to denature the proteins and bring about tenderness. There are other ways of improving or increasing the tenderness in meat. Like, for example, mechanically pounding the meat or mincing them will also help to break down the muscle fibers and the connective tissue between them and help to increase the tenderness in meat. This is one way of increasing the tenderness in meat. Meat can also be tenderized by changing the pH of the muscles. Say, for example, when we cook meat at home, it is usually marinated in an acid like yogurt or vinegar or lime juice, and this practice of using lime juice or vinegar also helps to improve the tenderness in meat. What else is there, ma'am, for improving? Okay. Now there are also proteolytic enzymes. There are certain proteolytic enzymes that are derived from the natural fruits and vegetables that help in increasing the tenderness in meat. See, for example, the enzyme papain that is obtained from the raw papaya also has a proteolytic effect and helps in tenderizing the meat. Apart from this, the bromelain from pineapple and ficin from fix also possess proteolytic properties and help in bringing about tenderness in meat. It is also said that in slaughterhouses, before the animal is killed, in order to improve the tenderness of meat, commercially prepared papain is injected into the vein of the animal before it is slaughtered, or it is smeared on the surface of the meat after the animal is killed. So these are some ways of improving tenderness in meat. What else? Idu ellam nadachu. I told about my point. 19 irka. I just discussed with you the different ways of tenderizing meat that has been stiffened because of rigor mortis. I told you about how meat can be tenderized by soaking it in a marinade containing an acid like a vinegar or lime juice or yogurt, and how these help in breaking up the connective tissue fibers between the muscle fibers, and how they help in improving the juiciness of meat. Apart from, I also told you about how proteolytic enzymes that are present in the raw papaya and in pineapple and figs, even how they contribute to the tenderness in meat. Apart from that, the tenderness of meat also depends on certain inherent characteristics of meat, like the age of the animal and the amount of the connective tissue. The muscle from the mature animal by virtue of its age is generally hard, and muscles that have a lot of connective tissue in them by nature are generally hard. And so meat that cannot be that does not become soft or pliable after rigor mortis has to be made tender by adopting certain artificial ways of tenderizing them. We will now shortly watch a video that will help us to understand the postmortem changes in meat better. Okay, with this we come to the end of this module. I hope that you have understood the physical and chemical changes that take place in meat after the animal is slaughtered. I also believe that you gained a good understanding of how rigor mortis sets in meat and how the aging or ripening of meat brings back its tenderness and juiciness once again. With this, we have come to the end of this module, and I believe that you've gained a good understanding of the physical and chemical changes that take place in muscle after the animal is slaughtered. I've taught you how rigor mortis sets in as a result of the fall in the ATP production and the increase in the lactic acid accumulation. I've also taught you about a few methods of tenderizing the stiff meat after rigor mortis has set in. With this, I believe that you understood how meat can be tenderized to increase its juiciness and make it more palatable. I now believe that you understood all the changes that take place before the muscle is converted to meat on your plate. Thank you.